TICO has become a broadly adopted technology for ultra-low latency, lightweight video compression. And the TICO Alliance has been formed to foster its adoption and interoperability. Now, suddenly we hear about this new codec coming up called TICO XS, and we ask ourselves the questions, why do we even need another codec? How is it actually related to the original TICO? It sounds an awful lot like this JPEG XS that everybody is talking about. Is that the same? I'm Niels from intoPIX, and I'm going to answer those questions for you in the next couple minutes. TICO was originally developed to replace uncompressed in the audiovisual industry. That's an industry in great change due to two factors. First, everybody is moving from SDI to IP or even virtualization. And secondly, video data is reaching unprecedented amounts thanks to 4K, 8K, HDR, high frame rates, the, and let me get this right, Joint Task Force for Network Media set up a roadmap in 2014 that visualizes this transition. Basically, what this shows us is a move from pure SDI to IP in roughly 6 years. Step number 0 and 1, the mapping of SDI and SDI over IP. That is defined by the ST2022-6, where the SDI signal consisting of audio, video, and auxiliary data in one package is simply mapped onto IP. Here, the original TICO RDD35 comes into play. By compressing at roughly 4 to 1, it allows you to put 4K streams instead of just HD on a 3G SDI, or even multiple 4K streams on a 10G Ethernet. From 2017, we started looking at step 2, which is elementary flows. Thanks to ST2110, we do not have a packaged SDI stream anymore, but separate audio, video, and auxiliary data that gets sent over the IP network. Hence, we have a separate video stream to be compressed, and even more now, we're facing addition 2.2.1.10, namely part 22, which defines a standardized way of compressed essence over IP. So it's a new use case. Would be great to have a codec that really suits this. And exactly that is why we came up with a new TICO product family member, namely TICO XS. TICO XS is a new TICO family member with increased compression efficiency. So depending on your content, we can compress, let's say, a 4K 60 stream somewhere down to 1.5 gigabit or even 500 megabit per second. On top, it keeps all the properties that we love so much about TICO RDD35, namely lossless quality, microsecond latency, a very low complexity, and extremely low power consumption. It does, and you're right, they're really much related. About the same time that ST2110 was coming up, the JPEG committee released a call for proposal for a new standard called JPEG XS. TICO was submitted and was actually selected as the baseline. After that, the intoPIX engineers, working together with the JPEG committee members, used TICO RDD35 as the basis to develop JPEG XS. So TICO XS is in fact compliant with JPEG XS, and that's a really important step for industry-wide adoption. Summed up, you're working with SDI or hybrid SDI IP, TICO RDD35 is your solution. If you're looking for higher compression efficiency, especially suited for ST2110 workflows, TICO XS is your go-to option. Therefore, TICO XS is not replacing TICO. It's merely an evolution that goes along with the technological development in the media industry. And best of all, it's ISO standardized as JPEG XS. You want more info? You're looking for a product powered by TICO compression? You want to implement TICO compression in your own product? Simply leave us a message or visit our website at tico-alliance.org. Join the Alliance with more than 50 industry-leading members.